Welcome back to the NYSORA YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to demonstrate the performance of the median nerve block for carpal tunnel surgery, but at the same time, we will use this as an excuse to demonstrate four simple ultrasound machine adjustments that can change the image to a substantially more favorable or better image for the given procedure. Let's get started. This machine over here is the BK3000. It's an older machine and has lots of adjustments of the machine. Before you start doing any imaging with the machine, you really should take a quick look to see whether somebody before you has tampered with the machine. And what I see over here is a time gain compensation control. As you could see, somebody has played at the time gain compensation control, and we would like to bring that back in the middle, in a neutral, and then adjust it from there on accordingly. So that's the first thing we're going to do. So here's the image that we have right now without any adjustments. And to my perception or to my liking, this image is a bit too bright. Likewise, it's too bright on the top and too bright on the bottom of the image. I don't have a great contrast of the median nerve and particularly not of the fascial sheets that we are interested when performing a median nerve block. So what we're going to do first is we're going to bring back the time gain compensation to the neutral. As we go back, that's the image that we have. So let's discuss this image over here. The image is too bright for my liking. So brightness is number one element that we would like to fix. Number two, what I would like to fix is the time gain compensation, because what I'm seeing here is that there's too much of the gain on top of the median nerve and the fascia that we are interested, and there's too much gain on the bottom part of the image, whereas I am not getting enough contrast around the median nerve and the fascial sheets that surround it, which is the most important for this particular block, as we will talk about. So number three, what I would like to adjust is something that's called dynamic range. What I mean by dynamic range is ultrasound waves have their own dynamics. So they are scatters or returns to the ultrasound probe that are very weak, and there are signals that are extremely strong. And when the dynamic range is very wide, then the difference between the weak signal and strong signal is way too much to be able to get a contrasty image that helps you recognize the fascial planes. So in this particular image, as you will see, the contrast is as much as 90 decibels. We would like to compress that. And once we compress that, we are going to get a lot more tighter, focused, and a lot more sharper contrasty image that is necessary to recognize these fascial planes. In the median nerve block procedure, what you really want to do is, it's not necessary to see very clearly the median nerve, but it's very necessary to see the fascia that envelop the median nerve. And these fascia are the fascias between the superficial flexors of the wrist and the deep flexors of the wrist. And this is where the injection of the local anesthetic wants to take place, so we can fill this space with the local anesthetic and then accomplish a median nerve block. But to accomplish that, we would like to accentuate that fascia, and therefore the dynamic range will be very useful with that. And finally, one last adjustment that we're going to do is, on this image, what I see is that the focus point is below the level of our anatomical interest. So we would like to raise this focal point to the level at which we have the structure of interest. So those are the four adjustments that I'll guide you through. Overall gain, time gain compensation, dynamic range, and the focus zone. So let's get started. So the first thing we're going to do is the overall gain. As we go back to that image, we can see now how the overall gain has gotten a little bit better. Now I can actually see the structure of these muscles, the superficial flexors and the deep flexors, and I'm starting to see a bit better of the fascia sheets that envelop the median nerve. The second adjustment that we're going to do is a time gain compensation. We're going to turn down the gain in the upper part and a turn down gain of the lower part of the image in order to accomplish, as you can see, this has been turned down, this has been turned down on the bottom. We left the center image untouched because we adjusted already the overall gain. And now this is the resulting image that we get. This image is a lot more pleasing to me. I can see better these fascial layers, but again, there's still some more work to be done as we move to step number 3, which is the dynamic range. Here we go. So on this machine over here, what I see now is the dynamic range has been set to 90 decibels. Okay, so if we take that dynamic range, which is huge, between the smallest, weakest signals and the strongest signals, and we compress that, we're going to get a lot more edgier image. So let's do that. We're going to use the trackball. We click on the dynamic range, and let's see what happens with the image as we manipulate the dynamic range. So that is the image that we get right now. As you could see, this is a lot more tighter, focused image. We lost some of the structures up on top and down on the bottom that we were not interested in, but we have substantially accentuated the fascial sheet. So now we exactly know where to go in order to accomplish the spread of the local anesthetic around the median nerve. The one thing that is still left to be improved upon is to see whether working with the focal point, we can actually get even more granularity or even more resolution to this image. So let's see that. So we're going to now go back to the controls on the ultrasound machine, and that's the indication where the focal point is, which is below the level of our interest. If you go to the controls of the machine, that is the button for the focal point right here, and we're going to use a trackball to raise that focal point up to the level of the nerve. And that's about the best I think we can do for this particular purpose. We don't have to spend much more time. But these adjustments take about literally 10 or 15 seconds to do, and they make a huge difference, particularly when the imaging is not that great. It's time to do the median nerve block. So we're going to use an aeroplane approach, and here's the probe in a transverse position. And now we're passing the needle aeroplane in order to pass it into the tissue plane between the fascia of the superficial and the deep flexors. The reason why that is important is because the nerve block is really an injection of the local anesthetic in the space that contains the nerve. In the median nerve block situation, that space is the fascial sheets of the superficial flexors and the deep flexors of the wrist. So the idea is that the needle passes in between those two fascia planes, and the injection of the local anesthetic separates the fascia so that the local anesthetic can get about the nerve in all directions underneath the fascia. This is why we spend so much time on optimizing the ultrasound machine so we can see the fascia, which are more important than the structure of the nerve itself, as we are not doing any diagnostics. Rather, we really want to find that fascial plane that is relevant for the block. Let's see the injection. As we start the injecting, we can see how the local anesthetic now pushes the nerve away and feels that fascial plane in between the superficial and deep fascia of the flexors of the wrist. And here we see a little bit of air being injected. We can see how far the local anesthetic reaches away from the injection, meaning that we are really injecting into the plane where the nerve resides. In summary, we demonstrated 4 simple ultrasound machine adjustments in order to get the best possible image for the median nerve block. What we did is we adjusted an overall gain. Number 2, we adjusted the time gain compensation to de-emphasize the structures above the nerve and below the nerve. We used the dynamic range and reduced it in order to accentuate the fascia sheets. As the image gets more compressed, it gets edgier and sharper for the fascial sheets recognitions. And number 4, we adjusted the focus point to get it into the level of the anatomical structures of interest for the median nerve block. Make sure you press the subscribe button and never miss the beat, as more videos will be coming soon.